The post-World War II era saw an explosion of federally funded competition against railroads. Air travel became practical thanks to the Federal Air Traffic Control System. The interstate highway system was built. Freight and passenger traffic plummeted, and railroads were again driven into bankruptcy or merger with mixed results. Now that World War II was over, the union had to redouble its struggle for the engineers.
After the war, the locomotive engineers were not on an equal footing with many other Americans. Wage and price controls had seriously eroded our standard of living, and the Brotherhood was determined to change that.
In 1946, the BLE and the Brotherhood of Railroad Trainmen went on strike. Trains across the country stopped running. Once again, the federal government stepped in. This time, however, the strike was ended on unfavorable terms, a meager pay increase.
Throughout the 50s and 60s, we fought for and won higher wages and railroad contributions to our health and welfare program. The BLE also created an apprentice engineer program, which gave aspiring engineers on-the-job training and assured them of a future in the industry. But those victories were offset by huge job losses caused by technology, like the diesel locomotive, which allowed a single engineer to operate multiple locomotives at once, and by taxpayer-supported competition in other transportation modes.
By the late 1960s, parts of the railroad industry flirted with extinction. A sea of red ink from passenger operations mandated by the federal government left railroads starved for cash, postponing track maintenance and creating a downward spiral. The 1970 bankruptcy of the Penn Central Railroad was the largest corporate failure in U.S. history. Several railroads faced total collapse and were in dire need of help. That help came in the form of government assistance. In 1970, Congress passed the Railroad Passenger Service Act, and Amtrak was born. 4 years later, the Regional Rail Reorganization Act led to the creation of Conrail from seven bankrupt Northeast railroads, including the Penn Central. These new government-backed railroads launched a massive downsizing process, leading to the abandonment of thousands of miles of track and the elimination of tens of thousands of jobs. The BLE fought successfully to save many thousands more miles of track and save thousands of engineers' jobs as well. But the bleeding continued as the Rock Island Railroad and the Milwaukee Road tumbled into bankruptcy in the mid-70s.
These laws created a new challenge for the BLE because a system that existed for a century was changing dramatically. The Brotherhood also had to fight to preserve and enhance safety because the government was considering eliminating locomotive inspections to reduce costs. We argued that fewer inspections would mean more accidents and increased injury and death to locomotive engineers.
And this time, the government heard them. The 1980 Federal Railroad Safety Authorization Act provided for additional safety inspectors as well as safety research and development programs. Also that year, the landmark Staggers Rail Act deregulated the industry. Railroads raised rates and abandoned unprofitable trackage or sold it to short lines and regional railroads. Engineers lost jobs by the hundreds or saw them replaced by much lower paying non-union jobs. But the Brotherhood continued the struggle.
The landscape of the industry was changing fast, with a profound impact on BLE members. Huge mergers shrunk the number of major carriers to seven, and federal certification of locomotive engineers created a much higher standard of individual accountability. Because so many changes were being driven by the political process, the Brotherhood launched a political action committee, today called the BLET PAC, to help elect labor-friendly candidates and have more influence in the legislative process.
Deregulation allowed the railroads to lower their costs, and the industry experienced a renaissance. Profits and ton mileage increased, and freight ton miles today are more than double what they were in the mid-1940s. Because of clogged highways, skyrocketing gas prices, and thanks to safe and reliable service, Amtrak sets new ridership records almost every year. Shipping rates today are about half of what they were before deregulation, and hundreds of billions of dollars have been reinvested into infrastructure. Once again, the railroads haul more freight than any other mode of transportation. Technological improvements have brought faster, more environmentally friendly trains equipped with the latest electronics. For engineers, this means great opportunity and great challenge. The locomotive engineer of 1863 struggled to contain the power of but a single iron horse. The men and women behind the throttle of a freight train today often use distributed power locomotives, operating several different sets of locomotives located in multiple places within the train. Parts of the train going uphill and other parts going downhill at the same time. 2-mile-long monster trains powered by 6 or 8 locomotives have stretched current signal systems to their capacity, and the union is a leading advocate for the installation of positive train control, an advanced GPS-based train control system to supplement current signal and other main track authority systems. Are the Brotherhood and its members up to the challenges of the 21st century?
State-of-the-art traffic control systems, expanded commuter rail service, and high-speed passenger rail lines are all being planned, developed, and constructed. The railroad industry is as strong as ever, and the future looks bright. And the Brotherhood is blessed with an incredible record of success to guide our work in the future as we meet the challenges of tomorrow.
Through it all, the Brotherhood has continued the struggle. In 2004, the BLE merged with the International Brotherhood of Teamsters and became the Brotherhood of Locomotive Engineers and Trainmen. Today, the BLET represents over 55,000 locomotive engineers and trainmen throughout the United States.
Railroads are as vital to America as ever, and the need for a union that struggles to improve wages and working conditions for locomotive engineers and trainmen is as urgent today as it was in 1863. This brotherhood will continue the struggle. We will continue to fight for better wages, improved benefits, and safer working conditions for BLET members, for Teamsters Rail Conference members, for railroad workers, for all union members, and for the American middle class. As a locomotive engineer, I can tell you that there's never been a life quite like ours. Today, the Brotherhood of Locomotive Engineers and Trainmen celebrates a proud tradition, as individual members and as a union, that has been 150 years in the making. And I thank you for celebrating our heritage with us.
Funding for this national BLET educational presentation has been provided by the North American Railway Foundation. NARF is a nonprofit operating foundation that was formed and funded by the Brotherhood's Relief and Compensation Fund to support rail history, education, safety, and technology in the United States and Canada. With continued Board of Directors stewardship coming from the BR and CF, NARF has supported many worthwhile projects over its 16-year history. The primary focus of these efforts has been in support of organized rail labor, giving back to all of the men and women of the railroad community across North America.